Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. So today I'll be talking about answer writing. This is a highly requested topic, so I'll be making few videos on it. I'll be not able to cover everything in a single video, so I'll be making few videos on it. So in today's video we will be talking about few topics. These are the topics. Topic one is when one can start practicing answer writing. Second is how to start, or this, what are the sources. And third one is what should be the strategy for framing answers. And last, I'll be showing you my sample answers. Okay, few of my sample answers. Now, the ideal time for starting answer writing. Okay, what should be the ideal time? In my opinion, you know, after covering your syllabus, the whole syllabus, as I have already told you in many videos, that please cover the syllabus, please read the syllabus before starting your preparations. Read the syllabus and the previous year questions several times. Okay, so after you complete reading all the topics in the syllabus at least once, okay, it would take you around, if you'd study for 4 to 5 hours daily to cover the whole syllabus once, to give it a first reading, it would take around 3 to 4 months. So after 3 to 4 months of reading the whole thing, you know, whole syllabus, then only I would suggest you to go for writing answers. Okay, some people also can do some like things like, you know, after covering a particular topic they can start writing answers, but I would not recommend that. I would say that please read the whole syllabus, everything. Just give it one reading, one simple reading. You don't have to, you know, mug up things in the first reading. Just give it one reading and then start writing answers. And as you will start writing answers, you will start to understand the topics. Okay, and then things would automatically, you know, get in your mind. Now, this was the first topic. Now, how to start, or what should be the sources? I mean, many people ask, ma'am, what are the questions where from we can start writing answers. Okay, so regarding this, I would say that, you know, just let me show you one question from the previous year in 2019. This is a question from 2019. Okay, just see the questions. Okay, the Great Revolt of 1857 was an important watershed in evolution of British policies towards colonial India. This is GS paper 2. What role did the moderates play in the formative stage of Indian National Congress? How did Jyotiba Phule influence the Dalit movement of Maharashtra? Briefly analyze Subhash Chandra Bose's contribution to the national movement of India. And what was the impact of press on Indian nationalism in the 19th century? So you have seen the questions. Now let me show you the syllabus, okay, the corresponding syllabus. This is the syllabus of modern history, okay, from which these questions were asked. Now, the question one was what? It was Great Revolt of 1857. See, the very first topic is Revolt of 1857. The second topic, the second question was what role did the moderates play? Now, see, then second topic, growth of Indian nationalism. No, not the second, it was third topic, Indian National Congress, formation, moderates and extremists. Now, look at the third question, how did Jyotiba Phule influence the Dalit movement? See, in the seventh topic, Dalit movements, Bengal, Bombay, Madras, presidencies. Now, the fourth question, briefly analyze Subhash Chandra Bose's contribution. Go to the syllabus. See, the 11th topic, role of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in national movement. And then the fifth question, what was the impact of press on Indian nationalism in the 19th century? Just go for the second topic, growth of Indian nationalism, historiography, causes, growth of organization, press and literature in 19th century. See, every question is directly or with a little twist being asked from the syllabus only. So you don't have to go to anywhere for your answer writing practice. Okay, just look at the syllabus, go for the topics of the syllabus and pick one topic and start writing answer on that. Suppose you have read today, you have read working class movement. Now just frame one question on this working class movement and then start writing answer on it. And framing one question on this working class movement is not very difficult. It is, you know, direct questions. What role did the working class people played in the Indian national movement? Simple. So such, you know, topics, go for the topics and frame such questions and start writing answers. This would be your preliminary work, okay? The first strategy for answer writing. Now, this topic, it is clear now, okay? The sources, just sources are, should be your syllabus and the previous year question. That's it. Now, the third point is, what should be the strategy for framing answers? Yeah, I mean, what should be the body, structure and everything of the answer? Now, this is a very, you know, general thing. Introduction, then body, then conclusion. This is a normal structure of a question of 5 marks or maybe 10 marks or maybe 14 marks question, okay? This is the general structure. In the introduction portion, just write 2 or 3 lines. At best, 4 lines, okay? At most, 4 lines on the question, on the keyword, on the main keyword of the question. Just let me give you one example. Just see, discuss the causes of Jamatia revolt, okay? Suppose this is the question, discuss the causes of Jamatia revolt. So in the introduction portion, just write 2 or 3 lines on the Jamatia, what is the Jamatia revolt, when did it started, okay? Then come for the body part. In the content portion, that is the body portion, this is your main marks fetching portion, okay? So here you just you can frame the content in form of heading, subheading, points, subpoints, diagram, maps, flowcharts, etc., okay? And not necessarily it should be like this, but you know, if you would frame this in form of heading or points or diagrams, it would be easier for the examiner to check your answer, okay? This is the motto behind you know, writing in points. So this question, what was the question? The causes of Jamatia revolt. Okay, so in the introduction portion you have said, what is Jamatia revolt, when did it start, okay? Now in the content portion, that is the body portion, main body, just write, just give one heading, causes of Jamatia revolt. This should be your heading, simple heading. Then after giving this heading, you just frame points, you just give some points and write the causes, okay? And then in the last part, that is the conclusion portion, you just say like this, okay, so these were the causes which which were behind the starting of the Jamatia revolt, or you know, 2 or 3 lines like this, okay? I mean, finish the whole discussion that you have made, okay? So this should be your structure for writing answers. Now let me show you my sample answers, okay? Few sample answers of mine. Let's say there's a question, reform measures of Maharaja Birendra Kishore Manikya, and actually this question came in our exam, in our main exam, okay? Why? Because you know, this was a direct topic. See, from history of Tripura, there are 4 Maharaja, of which you know, administrative and reform measures of Maharajas, 4 Maharajas, okay, and of which I chose to write this Bir Bikram Kishore Manikya. No, sorry, Birendra Kishore Manikya. Okay, so reform measures of Birendra Kishore Manikya. Now, this is the introduction part where I have written few lines about Maharaja Birendra Kishore Manikya, and then I jumped into the content portion. Innovations or you know, reform measures are noted below. This is kind of a you know, subheading, okay? Then I framed the formation, the reforms in points, in form of points, and then in the last portion I just wrote, thus the Maharaja has made had made his contribution towards modernization in almost all the branches of administration, executive, legislative and judicial. So see, this is a single line conclusion, okay? So this should be ideally the structure of a question and the structure of an answer, okay? Now let's see another answer. Now in this question, intensive subsistence agriculture. Now this is also a direct question that I chose from the topics of geography of India, I think. Yeah, geography of India. See, in the agriculture topic, extensive commercial agriculture, intensive subsistence agriculture, rice. Okay, so here I did not give any you know, introduction, because this is kind of a you know, factual based question, static question. So I did not give any introduction, but ideally you should give, okay? straight away I jumped into giving a map diagram of this you know major areas where rice is cultivated and other areas where rice is cultivated in India. And then I gave a flow diagram where I showed that what is farming, I mean how subsistence farming, intensive subsistence farming is linked to the farming. Okay, so here farming is the main kind, and then subsistence farming, commercial farming, and then intensive primitive, here in commercial farming, commercial grain mixed farming and plantation agriculture. So this can be considered kind of an introduction. Okay, now I jumped into what is intensive subsistence farming. So here I have written few points, and then I covered the topic rice, how it is an intensive subsistence farming. And then here also, again, I did not give any conclusion, but you should give, ideally you should give. So these are the answers that I, you know, that I wrote during my preparation time. So not every answer is a perfect answer. So here I missed the introduction and also the conclusion. You should give it, okay? So guys, that's it for today. I'll be talking about, you know, a few more things about this answer writing. And I'll be showing, you know, such examples how you can directly link your syllabus to the to framing answers, to framing questions, and then writing answers. Okay, so thank you for watching, and I'll meet you in my next video. Thank you.